Hey guys, it's Christina of Crafty Paws. I wanted to come on and share a little haul that I did at the Dollar Tree. And the first things are these really pretty fabric tapes. So they're like washi tape, except they're fabric. And I can't believe they were available at the Dollar Tree. There are a couple more patterns, but these are the ones that I really like. So I picked these up. I also picked up these little metal hooks. Now, they sell these like by 3M and stuff, and I have the kind of removable tape. We're in a rental right now, so I thought these would be great to just like hang up kitchen towels and stuff without making holes in the walls. Also, inside maybe my craft closet for some extra, tidying up storage. I also picked up this tool bench hardware tape, which is the clear tape. Now, the Dollar Tree also sells a smaller roll of packaging tape, and it has, like the little serrated edge where you can cut the tape and stuff. But this is like double the amount of tape for the same price. So I got a couple of these for sending off packages and happy mail. The next thing I picked up was this craft form, and they sell these at Michael's and stuff, but for a size that is about 10 inches in diameter, it's hard to beat a dollar. I wish they had a slightly larger form, but I have a project in mind, and if this turns out to be too small, I'll just make a wreath form out of cardboard or something. I also decided to pick up, and I haven't tried this. This is the foam sheets, and they're super thin, so I think they might be a little too thin to do any shakers or anything like that, but I could double or triple them up, and I think then it would be fine to create shakers or to even just add some dimension and raise up panels on cards and stuff like that. And again, at a dollar, it's hard to beat. I'm so excited about this, as I know it's silly. These are little name tags, but it had a little dog on it, so I thought these would be great to put like address labels and stuff like that for, again, sending off happy mail or racks. I also picked up this poster tack. This stuff is the stuff that you tear off and you kind of need to make warm, and you put it on the backs of posters, or in my case, tags that crafty friends have made for me, and you can adhere it to the walls, but it removes really cleanly, and you don't have to put holes or double-sided tape or anything like that to adhere things to walls. And then just for fun, I thought I would pick up this little hummingbird feeder. And I have no idea if hummingbirds actually come to where I live in the South. I mean, I know they exist out west where I grew up, but and I know they don't come into Manhattan where I used to live before, but I thought for a dollar it'd be fun to try and see if I can feed some hummingbirds. And then lastly, you guys are going to think I'm totally crazy, but I got a water pistol. And it's not for what you think, it's not to goof around with. It's actually because a little while back I was walking Biscuit and Bandito in a neighborhood park, and two dogs came rushing toward us. And it totally freaked me out. They were off leash, no owners in sight. I don't know where they came from. And they were really, really assertive. I won't say aggressive, but I had to pick up Biscuit and Bandito into my arms, and other people walking by had to kind of help me shoo them away. Both of the dogs were pit bull mixes, and while they weren't aggressive, Bendito was really scared and Biscuit was really agitated, barking and growling, and I didn't want there to be an incident. So for future walks, I thought I would be prepared. And so I decided I was going to get myself a water pistol, fill this up at least part way, so that if any loose dogs came our way, that I could spray water in their faces and hopefully distract them and shoo them away. I don't know what it is about this region, but I see loose dogs around all the time, something that I had never really seen in Southern California, where I grew up, and I never saw in Manhattan, certainly, because there's just so much traffic. People would be crazy to let their dogs out like that. But since that incident, I'd also heard from my sister and another friend that they have had friends of theirs attacked by dogs that are loose. So I don't want to face that situation, but I do want to continue walking my dog. So hopefully this will help. And if you guys have any suggestions, please leave them in the comments. I would love to know any other ideas where I can protect my dogs and myself from loose dogs while we go on walk. And that's it. That's my little haul and my little chat. I hope you guys are having a wonderful crafty day, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.